Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to create a custom numbered list in Adobe InDesign. So this is if you want something like a number and then parentheses after it. And I'll show you a few different ways. All right, let's get started. First, I'll open the document that I want to make the changes in. Now down here is where I want to add the numbering. And so I'll make a new paragraph style with the first numbered area selected. So I have it selected. I'm going to come down here and create a new paragraph style. And by the way, if you're not seeing paragraph styles, those are under Window, Styles, Paragraph Styles right here. So I'll create a new one. I'll double click it and I'm going to call it Level 1 Numbers. And then I'll come down here to bullets and numbering. Our list type will be numbers. Our level will be 1. I'm okay with the format being 1, 2, 3, 4. I just want to add a parenthesis around, for example, number 1. This number area is the key to doing that and making custom formats. This little caret means insert. So insert number, period, insert tab. And that's what's happening. We've got a number 1, period, and then a tab right here. You'll want to make sure that preview is checked. So if I want a parenthesis right here, all I have to do is find that period and put my cursor there and then just type a parenthesis. And to see the changes, you can just click into any other space. You can see now that we have 1 period right parenthesis. Now, I don't really like how the period looks, so I'm going to delete that. And here's what we've got now. This looks much better in my opinion. And now we'll say, okay, I have 3 places where I want to apply that paragraph style. So I'm going to select those and just click on Level 1 Numbers. And it probably makes sense to get rid of these colons, so I'll go ahead and do that. Now these are going to be level 2, and I want them to set in a little bit, and I also want to change the style. I don't want to use the same parenthesis style. I'll highlight my first level 2 section, and then I'll create a new paragraph style. I'll double click it, and I'm going to call this level 2. I'll come down here to bullets and numbering. My list type here will be numbers. My level will be 2. And this time I want my format, I want it to be lowercase Roman numerals. This time I'm going to delete everything in number. And then I'll use my flyout and choose insert number placeholder. And I'll choose level 2. And here's what happens when we do that. So I'm going to add a period. And then I'll insert another tab. So that's another way that you can customize. You can go ahead and insert your number placeholder here or enter a special character here. Now to get this to line up the way I want, I'm going to add a left indent. I'll highlight the whole thing and then I'm going to use my arrow keys to just move it over like this. And then I'm going to put a negative number here in my left indent. Okay, and this looks pretty good. So I'll say okay. Now I'll apply that paragraph style to all the rest of the number 2s. I think I'll rename this to level 1 number parenthesis. And I think this is a little too much space. I'm going to change my tab position here. I'll highlight that and use my down arrow. Then I'll say okay. And then maybe I'll update this spacing too. So I'll go into level 2. I'll get back on my bullets and numbering, and I'm going to change that left indent. Okay, and that looks better. So we'll say okay. Okay, now I want to take this a step further. Instead of having the lowercase Roman numerals here, I want it to say 1.1 and 1.2. So let's do that. That's going to be a change on our level 2 paragraph style. So I'm going to double click that, come down here to bullets and numbering. I'll go back to my 1, 2, 3, and 4 style, and then I'm going to delete everything under number. I'll insert a number placeholder here at level 1. So this has given us the first part of what we want. I'll add a period, and then I'll insert the number placeholder for level 2. And then I'll add another period, and I'll insert a tab. So this has given us what we want. We've got 1.1, 1.2, and then 2.1 and 2.2. Now, our tabs aren't looking very good, so I'll come up here to indents and spacing. And to fix it, I've changed my left indent to 0.5 inches and then put my first line indent at minus 0.25. And now everything lines up right here as it should. So I'll say okay. If you have a specific custom way that you want to set up your list, just let me know in the comments section and I might be able to help you. All right, if you liked this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.